Hi everyone, this is Maggie, the History Librarian. Today I'm going to walk you through finding some articles in Academic Search Complete for your History 209 course, Writing Assignment Number 5. I'm starting out here on the library website, which is located at library.uncg.edu. Before we jump into searching, I want to show you where the library chat service is located, here in the top right where it says Chat with a Librarian. This embedded chat service allows you to ask questions and get instantaneous help from the reference librarians and graduate research interns who are library and information science students at UNCG. The service is available Monday through Thursday from 8 a.m. to 11:45 p.m. Eastern Time, 10 to 5 on Saturday, noon to 11:45 p.m. on Sunday. So until almost midnight, 5 days a week, you can send a message and get an almost instant response. I'm going to say, hi, I need some help finding articles for my history class. And hit send, and you'll see that we'll get a response pretty quick. That is a real person. They are sitting in Jackson Library, ready and to help you with your research if you have any questions. So now that we are on the library website, I'm actually going to tell them, this is just Maggie demoing chat. I'm going to click on databases up here in the red box. And that will bring me to the list of databases where you can search for articles, ebook chapters, streaming videos, images, etc. The database that we're going to use today is Academic Search Complete, which is what was recommended by Professor Kellum. A link to Academic Search Complete is also in the assignment sheet on Google Docs for writing assignment number 5. I'm going to click on this here. And it automatically brings us to the advanced search page here on Academic Search Complete. I'm going to use this autobiography by Benazir Bhutto as my sample search. I'm going to just copy and paste this over to Academic Search Complete. And instead of having it all on one line, I'm going to move down Benazir Bhutto, the author and subject of the autobiography, onto the next line. And I'm actually going to put quotation marks around this so that it looks for every word on this line in this order, so that it finds works that mention the title. I'm going to go ahead and hit search. And so here we have, as you can see, mostly book reviews about the autobiography. If I click on this right here, this is information about this book review. And if I click on PDF full text over here, it will bring me to the text of the review. This one is quite short. Some reviews will be long and some will be short. And so it's up to you to decide if the article that you find is actually going to be lengthy and robust and useful enough for your writing assignment. On the right, there are several tools here, one of which is the Cite button. And if you click on this, you can scroll down to Chicago/Trabian Humanities and get a basic citation here in Chicago style. And then you can compare this to the template that Professor Kellum has on the assignment sheet to make sure that the generated citation here in the database looks like the correct format for a journal article in Chicago style. These aren't always perfect because a computer algorithm puts them together, not a person. So you always want to copy edit them to make sure that they're correct. So that's an example of a search for the title and author of the book. We can also go ahead and look at Professor Kellum's description here. And so one of the things that we might be interested in is her role in establishing the Council of Women World Leaders. So instead of having the title of the book, I'm going to search for this phrase instead. And so we're getting about 20 results. Not all of them are going to be in English. Some of them will be in other languages because we're talking about non-American women in these memoirs and autobiographies. Here, I can see that the subject is women leaders, political violence, Bhutto/Benazir. I'll click on this and scroll down. And so this is actually an article from Time Magazine, not an academic journal, which means that what we'll want to do is actually repeat this search. And maybe this time, instead of that phrase, we'll just search Pakistan and Prime Minister. And hit search. And now we have 669 results. And over here on the left, I can actually narrow them down to academic journals. And so as I'm scrolling down, the articles where Benazir Bhutto is listed as a subject of the article are probably going to be the most useful. This is actually an article, it looks like, by the former prime minister shortly before her death. And so again, this is information about the article itself, and I can access the article here on the left, either as HTML text or PDF text. You always want to choose PDF full text if it's available because it has the page numbers that you need to use for your footnotes in Chicago style when you paraphrase or quote or otherwise reference a text. And so here again, we have the article. In the PDF view, you can get to the citation by clicking on this button here. And again, scrolling down to Chicago Turabian. This is an example of how the database doesn't always create a perfect citation. Here, the author's name should not be in all caps. Instead, it should be in normal capitalization with just the initial letter capitalized. If we go back to the results, we can scroll down, and if you see something that says check for full text instead of having an icon indicating that the full text is available, the other thing you can do is click on this. And if we have the text available, you can click on view full text here and get to the article in a different database. This database here is JSTOR. You can either scroll through each page by using the arrow buttons here or download the PDF to be able to scroll vertically through the article. On the left, when we click cite this item, there is a Chicago citation here. And again, you want to double check before using it in your annotated bibliography to make sure that it's formatted correctly. If you need help with your citations, on the library research guides from the library website, which is, again, library.uncg.edu. Under research guides by subject, you can scroll to the bottom and go to additional research and resource guides, choose citation guides. And here we have a tab for Chicago style. You'll see also over here that my chat followed us around. The chat box is embedded throughout many of the library's pages. And so this is always useful if you have any questions, not just about your research, but about your citations as well. Speaking of research guides, I'm going to go back to the library website and briefly show you how to get to the history research guide by clicking on research guides by subject, scrolling down, and choosing history. Over here on the right, here's my photo. Again, the box, and you can also schedule an appointment for an online or face-to-face consultation with me if you need help with your research, or you can email me using my email address right here. If you have any questions about your research, please reach out. You can also message me through Canvas, and I look forward to hearing from you, and I hope you are able to find some great articles for your assignment. Have a great day.